All right, this is Shroud of the Avatar, and I am in Kiln, and I'm about to do the Kiln Cistern dungeon quest. The whole dungeon revolves around the Kiln Cistern. If you talk to Ivar here, he will talk to you about how the kiln's not functioning properly, and the alchemist who's in charge of it has disappeared. And so it's your job to, you know, go in and investigate. This is a really good dungeon. I'd say it's probably tier 3. Overall, at least tier 3. There's a couple entrances to passages and whatnot from here, but let's go in. And I've already completed it, so hopefully it's still doable, even though it's done, but we'll see. At least I can do a basic walkthrough of it for you. Again, really good encounter. I suggest you go, you know, do it yourself before you watch the video, if you want to do things like this on your own. Alright, so you're now down in the cistern, just like a typical sewer, visually. So let me turn here, let me go, oh, look at that, there's a contaminated water element, so I'm thinking that guy is the reason the water is bad, and what's in the problem with the cistern. But you can't get through here. So we have to figure out how to get to him and clear it out. All right, let's light some torches. Anything breakable? Let's throw on a light here too. All right. Oh, there's a ladder, but you can't get to it. That sucks. Okay. Breakables. I'm gonna play this like it's the first time. So I'm gonna break everything, kill everything, roam around looking for stuff. And again, I don't 100% remember it, so it's still fun. Alright, so it'd be nice to get over there to that ladder. Obviously, the breakables up here. If we jump in the water here, I can't seem to get up here. And how well I jump, it's just too high. At least for now. Maybe if you have the, that ring, is there a frog ring or something? Artifact that lets you jump higher? If you had that, you might be able to skip some parts of this dungeon. Alright. Definitely click on that. Can I click on it from here? Oh, you can. It's kind of messed up. But you can skip that. So, that is a... you can skip part of it by doing that. Let's go this way like we hadn't done that. There's not a lot of enemies in this area. So come here, and it's locked. Here, and I believe I have the key for this, yep. So that was the Midmar Passage key that I got. And you can get that, I'll show you a little bit down that way. So if you go this way, you can get into the Midmar Passage. Which way is it? Is there a break loop on here? So if you go this way, there, Midmar Passage. If you don't know, passages are open, are underworlds that are open to everyone. They're not dungeons or instanced like this is. So actually, it's going to be probably my next video. All right, so we need to get through here, but we can't because a switch is required. So we do need to go across here. But, and now that you know, you can... click on the switch from in here. I'm not sure if that's a bug or not. You can kind of skip this step of going that way. But I didn't know you could do that the first time I went through here, so I went this way. Alright, now there are all these notes everywhere. It's basically the alchemist writing notices not to play with the water levels. The idea there is to tell you that you can adjust the water levels. Pretty obvious, right? Oh, here's another one. I have a key for this one, too. My key broke for in use, but this is the Qual Passage. That's annoying. So if you go this way, you can go to Qual Passage. I believe it's through there. Yeah. And this way. It gives you the impression that you can go multiple ways, but it's really, there's the Qual Passage. So now we can get through multiple passages going that way. That's a dead end. Let's go this way, back the way we came. Back down to the main area. Let's go this way. So we go here. The water is actually high because I raised it, but we can't get through here no matter what we do. And there's no switch on this one, so you can't reach through and grab it. And there's no way to open this door. That's just another room in the dungeon for part of the puzzle. So we continue walking. Again, here's another room in the dungeon. You can't get in there, but the water is raised, again, because I raised it. So when you raise the water at that switch, I don't remember if there's more. I think it's just that switch. It raises it everywhere, okay, not just in the one room. All right, let's go back here, and then here's another room. Oh, look at that. There's a hidden door here. I believe this guy, if we go in here, this enemy will drop the key to the qual passage, I believe. So what do we have in here? No, we don't have anything. Let's explore a little bit over here. Get some torches, get some light going. As you can see, this goes up and this goes down. Like, this is the water level. So right now the water is up here as opposed to over here, and it does switch, I believe. Some stuff you can take for your house. Can't break that. Alright, go down here and you got, oh, look at that, two breakable walls. Let's start here. We will find out that and this probably goes to another passage. That's fine. So there's at least, and this is probably the Paladus passage, is this one. So, from this cistern, you can get to three separate passages, if I'm right. Here. Oh, you can't go anywhere through this one. But there's a torch here, like, giving you the idea that you can, but there's no breakable walls. Well, unless there's invisible walls. Nope. Alright. Ooh, that's a little... make me a little dizzy. Alright. Should break the second one. The holder of the key is probably in here, because normally it's roaming around here. At least I hope it's here. I just broke my key, so I want another one. I need a skill that lets me gives me. Oh, Black Blade Pass. Alright. So that's a scene. Alright, so I do not see the guardian of the key that's normally in here. That could be because either a bug, or maybe it doesn't spawn every time, or because I already completed it. But there is normally something in here, a guardian, that holds a key to probably that passage. So normally you'd come down here and you click on this to open to raise the water. So, but again, we've already done that. So, you can raise it and lower it as many times as you want, and there will be reasons to do that. So let's jump in. All right, turn that on. So before we, I don't think we can we go this way? We can. There's a water elemental. But we'll skip that for the moment. And go this way. Now remember, we couldn't pass those doors right there because the gate was locked. But now, after hitting the switch, we've opened the gate. And I believe it stays open. So now we can freely go back and forth. Which will be important later. So we go in here and we've got a water elemental and a roaring. So the regular water elementals are just normal water elementals. The roaring water elemental is a guardian of the key to that passage back there that we opened up. Water elementals aren't necessarily too tough. Where are my skills? Some of my skills aren't right. I don't have my main defensives. This isn't good. Anyway, water elementals aren't too tough. But they move a lot, and that's their main thing. For some reason, I have life tap up on my, or not life tap, but have to leave here. Tap soul up for some reason. Let's fix that. I don't think it'll follow me all the way in here. Alright. At least I have the right deck equipped. It's funny when I don't. Alright, so yeah, we don't need that. Clear that, and we want my primary defensive, which is... Pass it? No, here we go. Defensive stance. I'll leave that as a as locks because it's vital for my defensive ability. Alright, this time before we go in, let's buff up with some strength. Back here. And this is the only problem right there with the water elementals, is they like to just move. Constantly be moving around. Sometimes they don't stop and you're just chasing them the whole time. It's great when that happens. Ah. That's even better when they group up like that. Come on. Defensive. I'm going to talk about my defensive and I don't even use it. Alright, he's down. As you can see, the roaring had about twice the hit points of the regular. Again, it's the guardian. Just like in most mines and whatnot, you have a some sort of guardian of key, of a key. At least one key. Alright. They're down. Again, this is tier 3. You can do this as tier 3. So, I did this quite a while ago. And the roaring guy should have the key to the Quell Passage. And back when I was back in the other area, when I showed you in that back room, hidden door, there's normally another roaring water elemental back there that has the key to that Quell Passage. Again, I don't know why it was there. It wasn't there. Alright, so now we have the key to that, but we already did it. So we come through here, now we've opened this up. So we can go by now. To get back to the beginning. Now we'll go this way. A raging elemental. Now there is a story along with why the elementals are here and whatnot. And if you talk to the guy and read the notes you find along the way, you will kind of discover that story, which is pretty good. This is one of the better dungeons I've played. In size wise, for its size, it's story, the puzzle, and just the overall, you know, fun factor of it. I really like this one. I want more of these. All right. And there's the Midmar passage key. Some clay. And I gather everything. You never know when you might need it. And the one time you need it and you have the resources right there to build something, it's just so much easier. As opposed to, oh, now I need clay. I'm going to go waste an hour gathering clay. And then when you need it, you can't find it. So that's how it usually works. Alright, let's move into the next room. What do we get here? Break some barrels. So the water's up. We know that already, obviously. But we still can't. So we had to raise the water so we could get across that layer to open to open that back passage. Let me go in here, and there's no ladders, as you can see, to get up in here. That is closed. There's no switches anywhere. So the way we need to go is through there, right? But the water is up, so obviously we can't go underwater. It's not as of yet in the game. It would be great if they added underwater, non-combat underwater, so diving for treasure and going to caves and stuff. That'd be cool. So we're gonna go here, and instead of having to at least run all the way around, we can bypass that by hitting the switch from here. Nice. The problem, though, is we can't get back up. So now we're back down, and it raised the water everywhere, right? But that is why we hit that switch. So that's the first part of the puzzle. Opening the switch so we can get by. And the water elementals, the normal ones, will respawn, so be careful. Now we can continue on further into the dungeon. Alright, we're now in this room, and as you see, now we can get under. Jump down. And just for sake of argument, yeah, see there's no switch here or anything to click. That's where that elemental, the hidden door is for that elemental, for the key, the other key. There's no ladder here, so we can't get up. Alright, so. Alright. So we move in the next room. Let me look around and then, oh, we can go this way. Where does this go? This allows us to go basically back to where we were, but up top. So now we can, if the water's full, we can now come this way to jump to get back over here. If the water's full, if the water is up. And so let's go this way. So from here we've got, as you can see, three ladders. These ladders on the sides, you can only get up and down if the water's high. This one can get us up, and then there's a door right there. And this is the confusing part, if I remember. So, click on the note, and it says you can only have two doors open at a time. So if I, right now, you have that back door and this door open. So as you can see, this door is closed. And then the same thing, this door is closed, but that door is open. And if you go down, of course, you can't get up the higher things. So what do we do here? Get the switch. That'll open this door. In fact, let's do that so we can kill the elemental. Real quick. So that door closes, that door opens, right? And this door opens, and that door closes. We can't get through here because it's locked. Let's kill the elemental so we don't have to deal with it, at least for the time being. So obviously we need to get back behind some of these doors somehow. I can't remember if this is a mimic or not. No, I guess we'll hit it. The bar switches to... there we go. That wasn't. That's some decent stuff. Tailoring kit, some fragments, a little bit of actually a decent amount of gold for a chest. That's not bad. Alright, so can't get through, go down, we can't do anything. So let's jump down here. Now this is the part that I don't 100% remember, so we go through here. That lets us go up, around into here, into this side, but there's nothing we can do here. Let's go this way and see. So the water is down, letting us get through here. Alright. That. Can I open that? Oh, nice. Ah, so here. Look at this. You hit this cable here, or chain, drops the ladder. So now, and if you see where we're at, this is the beginning. There's the beginning of the start right here. So the idea behind that is now instead of having to go through all that, we can just go here. But we need to raise the water, right? Because we need to get to one of those, the top of the upper sides of those. So raise the water. As you see, the water's coming up everywhere. So now we can go back with the shortcut. Back up here. Not even though the water's up, we can swim perfectly underneath it. Alright, so we can go actually, this one we can't, if the water's up, you can't swim past it because there's a gate. So that's why we needed to hit the switch to open this door so that we could get through. Otherwise we've been stuck. We'd have to go back and lower it, switch it, and then raise it. So now let's go over here. Oh wait. We need to switch the gate. Okay. Because we want different doors open. See, we could just obviously go right through here. There's no point in that. We can't get through there. But if we hit the switch, see, now that gate's open, we can jump in and we can get up. Alright, so this gate is still locked, so we can't bypass anything yet. We go this way, so we can go down there and up there. Let's just go back here and check. Turn the light on. Oh, yeah, the switches. So this right here lets us bypass kind of that little area, jump back in the water here if we wanted to. Alright, I don't think there's anything low here, so let's jump into it, swim across. Oh, there's definitely, if you notice that, this half was swimming and this half was ledge. So if the water was not up, you wouldn't be able to get across here. Oh. Trip the water. That he was somehow carrying, he or she, whatever it was. I guess it doesn't have a gender. It's just an elemental, right? Although the fire elementals do seem female anatomically. Alright, so I don't see any switches or hidden things here. Gathered the clay deposit, of course. Ooh, some worms. Alright. I wonder if you could fish in an elemental, right? Because it's, you know, water. Bad joke. Alright. So we go this way. So it looks like we can get across there. Let's open this switch, though. By opening this switch, now we have this way so that we can get straight from here, straight into here. Now I have a feeling that we're going to have to go hit the water again. This last, it lets us get in there, but it looks like you can go through that gate, but of course there's no ladders. We can't get through here, of course, typically, because the water's high. So, too bad we can't get through there again. So now we gotta go hit the switch, the water switch again. But luckily we've opened up all these shortcuts. As long as I use them. Water elementals back corner there. Want to farm them? You know, they drop a decent amount of money. They aren't too difficult. Alright, so. Oh, I'm going to have to hit the switch, aren't I? Yep, alright. The switch to switch doors. Swim around. I mean, you could, I guess you could, as long as you could swim all the way around the long way. If you really wanted to. Right. It's a cool little puzzle. Again, recommend you do it on your own. I jump down since I get experience for my falling skill. It's funny, that jump right there gave me zero damage, but if you were a brand new player, that would take like half your health off at least. Alright, so now we're lowering the water. Now, the question is, am I doing this 100% right? Because maybe I was supposed to open or close a door back in that thing, and I didn't do it right, so we'll see. I think we're okay. So we go through here, and we drop down. Go through here, and we open that gate so we can get through. Otherwise, we would see, if you look, see it's deep on one side and then the ledge, we wouldn't be able to jump through, so we definitely did the right thing there. Alrighty. Now we can get through that gate. And I think we're getting near the end here. We have to be, right? Alright, what's this way? Oh, this just lets us go up here so we can bypass if we needed to. Let's continue. So what do we have? Oh, see, there's the... So we made it to the end. The contaminated water elemental. Alright, let's buff up. Hopefully we can kill it without dying. I'll let this... That's one thing I wish they would fix. Is having to wait for this to cycle to use my defensive. It means I have to stand here for no reason. Except for that. That's not cool. And it might have 1200 hit points, but because it's just a normal water elemental damage wise, and it moves a lot, so you don't really take a lot of damage. I say that and watch it gets a crit on me and I almost die or something, but if I could freeze it, if I could hit it. So, I'm going to run out of focus long before I run out of hit points at this point. Well, that was a nice hit and dot. Then, of course, I could probably play a little smarter and use some more combos and some stacking to save some focus. Not a big deal. Get back here. And unfortunately, you can't use focus potions if they aren't on your bar. So I'm stuck waiting for focus to regen. But luckily he's almost down. I just gotta get a few lucky hits in here. Alright, 17. There we go. And he's down. So now I got the Kiln Cistern Alchemist Key. Nothing to break. Who's this right here? Oh, there's the Alchemist. Pick him up and he gives you a note. Story-wise, you guys can read the note later. And we can't get through here, fortunately. A switch required. Where's the switch? It's probably in that extra room over there. There's some beakers. I guess he was testing water or whatnot, but the story is actually pretty interesting, so read the story. It really helps. Here's a key. Uses this, the Kiln Alchemist's key. Oh, there's the switch to the door. Yep, and now we can leave. Cool, so right back at the beginning. Not much here. Some books, some letters explaining, again, more of what's going on in here. I recommend you read them. Here you got a nice chest. Let me get out of here. A bunch of fragments, a scroll, and 106 gold. That's pretty good. So this is a nice chest. This is what, like, I want to see in chests. Maybe a little more. But yeah, this is nice. And an alchemist station, just regular. Some stuff you can take if you really want it. But yeah, so that is basically, omitting some of the story, that is basically the Kiln Cistern dungeon quest. With, as you can see, you can move into other passages. So, and then when you're done, you just go into the go back to the top and talk to Ivar. And the reward I received for this quest was 5,000 experience and 75 gold. So, again, good puzzle, good little boss fight, and it's just a fun dungeon overall. The only thing that I could ask for is if it was synced to my level, or the party leader's character level. I think that would make it great. Along with, of course, all the dungeons like that, but then I could rerun it, and it would be fun every time. And it was good this time. It wasn't too easy or too difficult. But yeah. All right.